Tell me about, I want to talk about a specific song. I'm sorry, Haunted Henry?
Yeah, Haunted Henry.
Haunted Henry. That was a song that, just upon cursory listen of the record, I thought, oh, well, that just because of the sound effects and stuff, and it seems sort of like a novelty piece or something. Mm. But then, lyrically, I was really grabbed by that song on personal listens. Really excited about the various layers of meaning on that song. It's at once maybe a childhood memory for you, or you somehow you seem involved in the story, but then there's also seems like a broader social commentary. Talk to me about those lyrics.
It is largely made up. I mean, it's fiction that I wrote. I wrote a story, but there are things I drew from. One is my uncle. Whose name is actually Henry.
Was he a war veteran?
Yeah, he didn't see like active combat, but he was in the military for a while in the 60s. I mean, he could have gone to Nam, but was stationed in Germany instead at the time. But it still did a number on him. And there is a reclusive element and very private element to him to this day, where it's a huge part of who he is, and it has shaped his personality and so forth. And it's never manifested in any detrimental way towards him to society at large or anything like that. I started drawing on the characters that you might see on TV shows or in movies, the psychologically tortured and traumatized Vietnam veteran type character, who then tries to reintegrate into society, and it projects itself and is unleashed in a myriad of uncomfortable ways for the community.
Well, in the song sort of reads like Henry's perhaps a serial killer, or that he's eating small children in the basement, or having sexual experiences with himself, or with something.
Exactly, all the above. That's, I mean, I like keeping my lyrics, read into them what you will, and implying a lot of things. A lot of my lyrical heroes do that, and I love it. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you kind of get the gist.
I believe you used the words soldiers and seamen or something, yeah. Right?
Right, and you're probably one of 50 people who picked up on that wordplay. You know, I mean, right, it's a moment of lyrical wordplay I probably labored over for half a day. And so thank God you picked it up. I wanted to see if I could paint that picture then musically. Back it up, create that mood, that environment, just thought it made for a good kind of creepy pop story.
Well, you know,
it's another pop genre, the creepy horror pop that a lot of psychedelic bands did in the 60s.
Yeah, well, is it surf or is it sort of monster jazzy? Yeah, it's a hard genre to define stylistically. Tell me then, you know what I found was really exciting is that people have come to expect a lot of dexterity and how do you say, just sort of accuracy in your music. You know, it's very clean, it's very tight, the corners are sharp, the turns are quick, you know, blink and you'll fall off the road. And in that song there's this big, all the saws and the footsteps are all out of time. And I just loved that bold stroke. Amid all of the ordnung, to have this, you know, thing across it. I thought that was pretty brilliant, actually.
Thank you. I mean, that was deliberate because at the time the sound effects just seemed a little too elemental and predictable and obvious to me. I wanted to make it more cinematic. I wanted everything to drift and have the time be more implied and then it all lock into place. And I have friends who work in TV and film, and they put me up with some sound libraries, and I really went to town on it because, again, it's all about putting a listener in a space immediately. Mm-hmm. I don't care if they're out jogging with their iPod or stuck on 101 in traffic. I want to transport them out of there, as my heroes have done for me.